Now Probert got the right hand free.
He's loose with the right hand, and he starts to retaliate, and down goes Nyland, and the two of them are hammering each other.
Knights of Columbus, that hurt!
It's old time hockey, the way you're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets in your way. You play like Gordy Howe or Eddie fucking Shore. We can't all be Gretzky's, the loser Bobby Orr's. Hey.
The enforcer of all hockey podcasts. It's the Biscuit. It's the Biscuit.
Damn it! Set goal regulation size or what?
The enforcer of all hockey podcasts.
God help the fucking day if fighting's ever banned. As a country will stop working on Sabbath's fucking can.
Hi, everybody. It's the Biscuit Podcast.
Hey, you want to go? Yeah, okay. Good luck to you too, buddy.
Welcome, Biscuit Babies, and welcome to The Biscuit, brought to you today by Lucid Float Spas out of Mount Vernon, Ohio. Randy, what do you do when you're feeling like shit?
I drive 4.5 hours to Mount Vernon, and I hop in a Lucid Float Spa.
God damn it, the smartest thing you ever said in your fucking life. Let me ask you another question, Randy. Where do you get your CBD oil?
Where do you get your CBD oil?
ParkersPlatoon.org.
That's where I find it. ParkersPlatoon.
Oh, and I feel good, and then I feel good about, you know, helping out veterans. Why not?
Yeah. I buy stuff from there. I bought that awesome-ass bracelet.
Yeah, how sick is that thing?
Yeah, I love it. It's a paracord bracelet, and it's the end caps are two bullets.
Hopefully used to kill some communists. Did you hear Mr. Trump is going to go meet Rocket Man?
No, but I seen he fired someone via tweet, which was pretty cool.
Oh, hell yeah.
He fired the Secretary of State or some shit.
Hold up one second. Okay. Yeah, he's a wild man, isn't he? And then also, you drive what, about an hour to work every day?
Yeah, 45 minutes.
Have you ever thought about going to audible.com/trial and typing in the word hockey? Or
no.
audibletrial.com/hockey? Well, I did it this week, and it's the History of Hockey podcast is now sponsored by audible.com. It's audiobooks. Oh. And I got a free book, Mr. Hockey, The Story of Gordie Howe, and I listened to it at work this week, and it was good. Is it good?
Yeah, I'll check it out.
It was free, good way to burn 6 hours.
Yeah, I can listen to it on my way to work, and I can listen to my headphones at work now.
Oh, yeah. I have to sneak mine up my ass so nobody fucking yells at me.
Yeah, I just sit at my desk and wear them.
Huh. But I know there's Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe's story. Sean Avery has his book on there. I think it's I Fucked Your Wife or something. And then I tried to look up Jordan Tutu's book and John Scott's book, but I couldn't find him. And I didn't feel like spending a lot of time on audible.com. But go help out Shane and the History of Hockey podcast. And go to, I think it's audibletrial.com/hockey. And, you know, send shit his way. That's all for the reads. I think that's the first time you've ever done the reads with me. Congratulations.
Nice.
And congratulations to me for turning 31.
Yeah, it's about time.
I want to thank everybody online for sending me happy birthdays. Griffin at the All Beard No Teeth. Stephen Bentley, even though he's an LA Kings fan. Just a lot of love on the internet. I got literally probably the most spoiled I've ever been, probably since like my Ninja Turtles birthday party when I was a kid. I got all kinds of cool shit from my wife.
Nice.
Yeah, man. Oh, and it was Brett Harvey's birthday on the same day, the director of Ice Guardians. So happy birthday to him too.
Hell yeah.
All right, buddy. You ready to get into it?
Do it.
I want to focus quite a bit of the episode on college hockey, if that's all right with you.
Yeah.
First off, I'd like to say the people that run NHL.com must run all these hockey conferences websites too. And whoever those nerds are, they get the fuck boy of the week because every single one of their websites is dog shit.
Yeah.
It took me an hour and 45 minutes to find out their schedules.
I keep a Notre Dame schedule in my wallet.
That's a fucking American there. Speaking of Notre Dame, holy shit, wow.
I woke up my newborn, not newborn, but basically, I mean, she's 8 months, 9 months old, woke her ass up after that goal.
30 seconds left, or 35 seconds left, right?
31.
Was it 2-2 at the time?
2-2. It was 2-1 after the first period. Or actually, it might have been 2-2 after the first period. Either way, it was 2-2, like, super quick, whether it was beginning of the second or – and it was super exciting.
Notre Dame versus Penn State is the game we're talking about.
The last 5 minutes of that third period was nuts. Penn State had endless amounts of chances. Notre Dame had chances. I didn't think anyone was going to score, and I don't think they would have went to a shootout because I don't know if they do that in the tournaments in college.
Well, they can't have a fucking tie.
I think they just play like old NHL days when they used to play seven periods.
Well, I know for sure in the Frozen Four they at least go to two overtimes because the – what was that, South Dakota game last year?
Yeah, I'm telling you, I think they do like three.
It was North Dakota, I'm sorry, right?
Yeah, and that's the old NHL way. Then they used to play three periods. I've seen teams play two games.
That was one of the best college hockey games I'd ever seen in my life.
Yeah, and then that dude cheated.
Oh,
that was that call, wasn't it?
It was the offsides, but he was
offsides, yeah.
But he was offsides. Or he wasn't offsides. They called offsides, so they counted the goal, went to overtime. It was crazy. They ended up scoring, I think, after that botched offsides that took about 30 minutes to figure out.
Yeah, that shit was nuts.
And the commentators were literally running out of words to use.
Yeah, and the players were running out of juice. Then you made them sit there for 20 minutes.
Who was it against?
I can't remember. Minnesota, maybe.
Boston?
Yeah.
Was it against Boston?
Yeah, because I almost said Boston when you said North Dakota earlier, so now I know.
That's what I'm thinking, too. So anyway, and then on the other side of the Big Ten tournament, Ohio State goes to overtime with the – I mean – Not like the football, but still rival. And, you know, University of Michigan has basically owned them forever in hockey, but they beat them in overtime 3-2.
Yeah.
And I think I said last week or the week before, my favorites going into this tournament were Notre Dame, obviously. I mean, that's a fanboy pick. And then I thought Ohio State was a scary team going into this tournament.
Yeah, the Big Ten tournament?
Yeah, absolutely. So they match up on Saturday for the Big Ten title.
Yep.
And Notre Dame should be a shoe-in already to the Frozen Four.
Yeah, but they don't win this, they're not going to get a one seed.
Right, and that one seed, I mean, you want it. Why wouldn't you want it?
Yeah.
But if you get Ohio State to win, because Ohio State's a set for, you know, for all intents and purposes, a bubble team. So, I mean, if they lose, they could miss the tournament.
No.
You don't think so?
No, they've only lost like 8 games all year.
Yeah, but I mean Boston College they have to play each other, so one of them are losing. And that's a semifinal game. You got Minnesota, Duluth, and Denver have to play each other still. North Dakota and St. Cloud have to play each other still. So Friday,
fifth in the nation.
On what fucking website?
Huh?
On what website?
NCAA.com.
I use BarstoolSports.com.
Fuck Barstool Sports.
But what I'm saying is,
where does Barstool Sports have them?
I don't even know. I haven't looked. Probably pretty high. Probably number five. Probably exactly number five.
Because they're like the only reason they're not ranked. They have 5 ties, and that kind of makes their record weird.
Well, fucking win games, don't tie. This isn't Canada. Yeah.
I know, and I mean, like, Notre Dame's 24-9.
Right.
That's what they don't tie.
Right. So the regular season champs, you got St. Cloud that won the NCHC. Big Red Cornell won the ECAC.
Yeah. Minnesota. And that's 1-2.
What are they?
That's 1-2 in the nation.
St. Cloud being number one, right?
Yeah, and then Cornell. And then Notre Dame.
And then Minnesota State won the regular season West Coast Hockey Association. And they just got beat by Michigan Tech, so they're not even in the championship game for the WCHA on Saturday. So you're gonna have two teams from the WCHA going, which is pretty cool. And then Boston College won the Hockey East, and Mercyhurst won the Atlantic Hockey. And Atlantic Hockey has the worst website of all the conferences, except for their Sweet Labatt Blue logo. So good on them for that.
Nice.
Which seems weird that, because as an NCAA team, you can't be sponsored by beer, can you? Or does hockey just have it like that?
No, I don't think you can.
And, I mean, one, fuck the NCAA. It's bullshit that, you know, obviously these kids aren't making as much money as, like, the college football players or basketball players. But it's still fucked up. Like, they should be, like, you know, juniors. Give them fucking something. But
yeah,
it's a little different. It's a little different in hockey just because most of these kids aren't coming. They're not going one and dones, you know?
Yeah.
Like, college basketball, but a lot of those kids are going just because they have to.
Yeah.
So I guess it is a little different. I still take issue with it, though.
I was trying to go to the game Saturday.
Why don't you just do it? YOLO.
I don't know.
You just got a fucking promotion. You know you just got tax money.
I haven't done my taxes.
You have to have done them.
I haven't turned them in yet.
The day, like the due day is like tomorrow.
Due day is April 10th.
Who the fuck is calling you?
April 12th. Mom.
Our mother that's in my living room right now?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm out in the studio. I told her, like, because I got her to come babysit the kids, and I was like, oh, I'm going to go talk to Randy. So that's – she's probably I'm watching the kids.
Trying to FaceTime me.
Oh, God. She's a real beauty. So I don't know how many of these games are going to be on TV Friday and Saturday, but I hope – I mean, obviously the Big Ten game is going to be on.
Yeah, it's on TV. It's on ESPN. Big Ten Network, 8 o'clock.
The Ocho. I got Big Ten Network.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch that. They're last week. 8 o'clock?
Yeah.
And I did bet Hoover.
Hoovdak.
Who's running before school? Might be a serial killer? He said he was listening to the podcast running before school the other day. I said, what time the fuck does school start? Like 6 o'clock, doesn't it?
No, like 7:45.
Dude, they run those things like fucking concentration camps. They're in there fucking burning at like 6.
No way. 7:45 minimum.
Either way, you don't need to be up before that running. But so the bet is, obviously when Notre Dame wins, Hoover's going to have to wear a Notre Dame shirt to an Ohio State, hockey game next season.
Nice.
Speaking of bets, we got Picklegate going on too right now. Laura Jo owes me, she's trying to get out of it. She's talking about breast milk and all this bullshit.
I'm kind of real mad. Last night I lost the humor went out of it and I just got upset.
No, I think tonight when she falls asleep, I'm going to go grab the pickle and put it by her face when she's sleeping. It's like a pound. It's a 1 pound pickle in a bag from a gas station in Belleville, Ohio. Okay.
They have them in my vending machine at work. I think I'm going to videotape myself eating one at my desk.
Dude, fucking narc.
They're not spicy at work. They're just the regular Big Papas.
Well, this one's not spicy either. I couldn't find the hot one.
Oh, what? It's not even – it's – yeah, that's what I thought. The hot mama's the hot one.
Yeah, I can't find a hot one or I'd get that. The issue's not that the pickle's not delicious. It's just so much pickle.
Get one of them hot pickled sausages instead.
And I told her she can't use a fork or a knife or anything either. And she's like, well, now it's just getting really sexual. I was like, well, that's your problem. I'm not the one going to be on YouTube. You are. You fucking blame Dylan Larkin, Anthony Mantha, and the other losers on the Red Wings that can't win a fucking game.
Yeah, Luke Witkowski.
Excuse me?
I said Luke.
I said losers.
Luke Witkowski is not a loser?
Fuck no, he's a winner through and through. He might be my favorite player in the league right now.
Alright.
But since you won't count hits in our fucking fantasy team.
Yeah, because that's stupid.
Oh, my God, dude. We'll talk about that later. So you got the games, the semifinal games and final games this weekend. On Saturday, you got the WCHA, Michigan Tech, John Scott alumni, versus Northern Michigan. Who you got in that one?
I'd like to say Michigan Tech.
I'm leaning towards Michigan Tech. They just had a huge win coming into the weekend, so I think they're going to ride that wave right over the Northern Michigan team. NCHC on Friday, you got North Dakota versus St. This conference is retarded. You got North Dakota versus St. Cloud, and then you got Minnesota Duluth versus Denver. Fuck you.
Yeah.
One of those four teams could win the Natty.
North Dakota is not as good as they have been.
But they have that thing around them where it's like Alabama football. You just kind of...
But I mean, when you're... Let's see. They're 16 and 12.
Okay. They're 16 and 12?
Yeah, but listen. They're ranked 12 over teams that have 20, 25, 23, 21, 19 wins all behind them in covering the top 20, and they're at 12.
Well, I'll say this for hockey ratings, and at least college hockey ratings, that they look at the team. They really don't give a fuck about the record.
Well, like I said, you lost three times to St. Cloud State and twice to Denver. Right there is five.
Exactly. You know what I mean? You have to play, yeah, those teams fucking four times each. It's a shit show.
It's not like you were shitty.
Who do you think makes it? You think St. Cloud rolls them?
I think St. Cloud wins.
I think St. Cloud wins, and I think Denver wins, and I think Denver ultimately beats St. Cloud.
I don't know. St. Cloud State's playing really good.
Oh, okay. So just go with what everyone else says. Big Rand's picking St. Cloud State. What a fucking going out.
You picked Denver. It's like
ECAC. You got the fucking Princeton. Are they the Tigers or the Princeton Princes?
Who are they playing?
Fucking Big Red. The fucking Andy fucking Big Red Cornell. That's a big red bear.
That's a big red bear.
That's a big red bear. And
Andy and the tuna.
I want to do my magical. What's the fucking bird thing? Every day I follow, every day I see. Who's got my freaking phone?
Who put my stapler in Jell-O?
Michael, Jim put my stapler in Jell-O again. Then you got Dodson and Harvard versus Clarkson. I'm picking Big Red just simply because of Andy from The Office.
Yeah, I'm rocking Big Red Bear.
Clarkson's super good. Clarkson's had a great year. But Dodson is in fucking freak mode.
Yeah.
Is this Dodson?
My name's not fucking Warren.
It's not Dodson. What's that fucking guy's name from the Olympic team?
Dasu?
No, the fucking Americans, man. Kid plays for Harvard. Look him up. It's Dodson? Dodson?
Samsonite?
My name's not fucking Warren. Hey, if anybody can name that movie reference, tweet it to me and I'll send you a fucking beer koozie and a 7-inch record.
My name's not fucking Warren.
My name's not fucking Warren. Tweet it to me, first one to do it. I'll fucking mail it to you.
You know, there was, is it Eddie Ellis?
Dodson. Donato. Jesus Jack fucking Christ. Donato. I might be a fucking communist. I can't even remember Donato's fucking name.
And his brother, Ryan Donato. Which one was it?
What were the names?
Ryan and Jack Donato.
It's Ryan Donato, isn't it?
He's older, so I would imagine.
Yeah, he's the good one.
And then there's Frederick Giorgio.
I'll just fucking look back at my goddamn Olympic notes here. Where you at, bud? How many fucking pages ago was that?
Ryan Donato's on the USA team.
Okay, that's what I fucking thought. Jesus Christ. Sorry about that, guys. There's been a, you know, fuck you. I drank a lot this weekend.
And he plays, he's actually drafted by the Bruins.
Yeah, the Bruins, mark my words, are going to win a cup in the next 5 years.
When he was fucking 12, apparently, because he's just a sophomore.
Yeah, with, you got Anders Bjork, you got Charlie McAvoy, Donato's going to play next year.
Yeah.
They've got a couple other young fucking studs. DeBrusque is fucking good. I don't know what they got coming up the pipe goalie-wise, but they're a fucking tough-ass team. Yeah, so I see Harvard against Big Red, and I think Harvard wins that easily. With Donato just dropping fucking pucks on everybody.
Sexy Rexy.
Hockey East, you got the Battle of Boston, BU versus BC, and Providence versus Northeastern. Who you like out of that? And fuck you, Providence, for being the Friars. Change your fucking mascot.
I think Providence is going to win the Hockey East.
They're going to win the Hockey East. I think they'll beat Northeastern, but they're definitely not winning the Hockey East.
I don't even know if they'll beat. I think whoever wins Northeastern Providence,
Boston, baby, go Terriers, no, go Terriers.
Whoever does, I don't know. Providence is good. I've got the pleasure of watching the Hockey East live for about 4 years, watching ND play until this year.
We stayed in the Hood in Providence once. There is a Hood of Providence. It's weird. It's like shady white dude Hood. And we slept in this loft on tour. And the dude that let us stay at his house, I forget what band he was in, the Network or some shit.
The Friars.
He was part of the Friars. But he banged the shit out of this chick in this loft while we were all sleeping in there. It was super weird. I'll never forget it. I remember being like, I couldn't sleep, and like James and Ronnie and I were all sharing like one sleeping bag, and I was like, dude, you guys fucking hearing this dude rail this chick? And someone was probably jerked off. It was weird. That's tour life. I think that was before we went and recorded in Salem, actually. Fuck if I know. Atlantic Hockey. Mercyhurst versus Robert Morris.
Mercyhurst.
Yeah. Robert Morris, I don't even think, has business being in the game, so I don't think they're expecting much. And then you got, man, this fucking school is Canisius.
Prometheus Bob
versus Air Force. But Canisius, they're the fucking Golden Griffins. How badass is that?
Yeah, Prometheus is beating the Air Force.
And they're from Buffalo. They might be my new favorite fucking university. They're probably a college.
Prometheus.
But go on YouTube. They have a Cribs edition of their hockey house from 2014. It's pretty badass.
Prometheus Bob and the Golden Griffins.
All right, those are the picks for championship weekend. Bet on them, because we know what the fuck we're talking about. I guarantee all those picks. But I'd have to say, I really think Notre Dame's going to win the Natty this year.
I fucking lose my mind.
Oh, it's going to be fucking awesome. It's going to be so awesome. End of the year injuries. A couple of young guys went out in the NHL. Charlie McAvoy and Brock Besser. I think Besser was probably the favorite to win the Calder, wouldn't you think?
Yeah, he was doing really well.
I don't expect either of them to come back. Obviously, it doesn't matter much for Vancouver. You might as well leave Besser out for the rest of the season anyway. Just, I mean, why bring him back in? And then Seth Jones, who I think is making a fucking argument to put him in for a Norris Trophy, got hurt last night against the Habitant. I haven't heard otherwise, but I think it was a lower body injury. I don't think it was that severe. I think he'll be back. But he's got like 15 goals on the season now. And he's just realized over like the last week that he's 6'4", 220 pounds. And just like in particular the Vegas Golden Knights game, he was just crushing motherfuckers. And was like finally like, oh shit, I can just like Popeye Jones these fools.
Yeah, he's playing really well lately.
If he isn't nominated this year or one of the finals, he will be one of the three finalists for the Norris next year, guaranteed. Guaranteed it. And then my boy Shifley is out again for like
Shiffle.
Fucking that dude is killing me. We're in the UBL playoffs now. First round being you versus me, and then Brent Curry of the Flint Generals versus our older brother, Brennan. Hey, you other fucking losers. How did you let Brennan, who's never watched a hockey game in his life, get into the fucking playoffs?
He barely made it, but he almost squeaked you into a bad situation.
Dude, I just fucked Curry up last week.
I just fucked... what's he saying on fucking Big Lebowski? I fuck you next week.
Hey, fuck you. Hey, fuck you.
I just bought that car last week.
I just bought that fucking car last week, man.
Fuck my car.
Fuck your car. And I would be nervous if I were you, because this is about the time of the year where you'll see Malkin go out with a lower body injury for like a week.
Yeah, the number one player in fantasy hockey.
Because playoffs are coming. And Penguins, I mean, they're legendary for this. Like, either him or Sidney would be like, I think they roll the dice and be like, okay, who's taking the last week and a half off? Say I'm hurt and then roll into the playoffs, you know.
Hope it's not the number one player in fantasy sports.
Is he really?
Yes. Yeah, fucking head out of your ass.
He doesn't. How is he?
He's got 319 fantasy points.
He doesn't even have the most power play goals. He doesn't even have the most goals. He doesn't even have the most assists. So how is he?
39 goals, 48 assists.
Yeah, chump change.
Are you kidding me?
He's not even the best Russian in the league.
Jeez.
Who is? Maybe the best Russian player of all time, sir.
Alexander Radulov?
Yeah. Literally, Alex Ovechkin might be the best Russian athlete of all time.
Okay, here's your Ovi. You want Ovi's fantasy points?
Yeah. 250. What's he got?
258. He's ranked second.
How many goals does that motherfucker have? 40?
42.
Does he really?
And 32 assists. So Malkin has more points. So I'm telling you, Malkin is your fucking heart winner. He's everything.
Okay, so Ovechkin just got his 600th goal last night, right?
And 601, same night.
Good God. What a freak. That puts him, I think, second and most points as a Russian ever?
I'm not sure. He's the fourth fastest to 600. I know that.
And who are the three ahead of him? Fucking Gretzky, Brett Hull, and...
Uh,
Who's the other one got to be?
Probably Gord.
No, Gord took forever.
Did he?
Gord played for fucking 50 years.
Yeah, but he scored so many goals in the beginning.
Gretzky, Hall.
Crosby?
Jesus fucking Christ. Well, Fedorov has 1,179 NHL points. Obi's got 1,035. Fedorov dropped 56 in a career high. Obi's had over 56 in the season, hasn't he?
Obi? More than 56? I don't know. I would have to look at his career stats there.
I got a bunch of fucking hockey cards over here. I guarantee there's an Ovechkin card right here. I know there is, actually. It's the one you gave me. That fucking badass captain one.
Oh, nice.
All right, Ovi. The past, there's only fucking 4 years on here. 53 is the highest in the past 4 years. Why would you only put 4 years of stats on here? That's the fucking internet ruining hockey cards. I need four all. I need.
Years.
They just did. They just do the past 4 years. They're your fucking Parker's cards, not mine.
Oh yeah, those Parker's.
When you bought the
I just bought shit ton of Upper Deck cards the other day and got no one pull.
Nothing. Nothing. Not one pull.
I was so fucking mad.
That never happens. Every time I buy a pack of Upper Deck, I get at least one fucking sweet ass card.
I bought. I mean, I got a couple. There was some OVs and some other cool stuff. I mean, it just pissed me off.
Hey, make sure you bring Bronson's twig down, and so I need some hockey tape too.
Okay. I can bring some. What about Messier or
fastest to 600 goals?
I wonder how fast Jágr did it.
Oh, he's the other one, right?
I mean, I don't think Messier was that quick because but Jágr ended with 765. But the last 165 were within like 13 years.
Like, what a shame that guy left.
Yeah, that was messed up.
That's shit that, like, they need to, like, not let happen.
Yeah, I imagine it's Gretzky, Jágr, and Hall that are the fastest of 600 besides Ovi.
Yeah, I think so. But what I'm saying here, the point is, I think Alex Ovechkin might be the best Russian athlete of all time.
Athlete. Oh, is Mario Lemieux. It's Mario.
Oh, Lemieux. Holy fuck. How did you not think of fucking Mario?
Because I thought Jágr was quicker.
No, dude, Mario was a fucking monster.
Yeah. You'll hear dumbasses compare him to being better than Gretzky.
I mean, this whole anybody better than Gretzky thing's got to end.
Well, that's what I say. People like, I mean, Mario's stats and like other things, like semi compare, but not really. There was 1 year Gretzky had like 170,000 points.
Like, and I, you know, it would have been awesome if Mario would have never got hurt. I mean, who knows what would have happened with him too? But like, the greatest hockey player of all time is Wayne Gretzky. Like, it's...
Yeah, it's not even... I don't even know why people talk about it.
Every asset... I mean, he changed... I don't even want to hear about it. I don't even want to fucking hear about it. But, okay, so maybe he's not the best Russian... I mean, name a better Russian athlete.
5 years in a row, Wayne Gretzky had 200 or more points in the NHL.
Jesus fucking Christ. Think about that.
5 years in a row, he had more than 200 points. On a stretch of 92, 71, 87, 73.
What? 52. How did he have more than 200 points?
Those are goals, huh? He had 92 goals and 120 assists in one season. That's 212.
Are you fucking serious?
71 goals, 125 assists the next year. 87 goals, 118 assists the next year. 73 goals, 135 assists the next year. 52 goals off year, 163 assists, made up for it in 163 fucking assists, and then followed the next season with 62 goals.
Oh, okay. So, like, I knew he was the best, but, like, I've never really, like, read those numbers.
Yeah, his stats are fucking stupid.
92?
Goals in 1 year, yeah. That's more than a goal a game. He only played 80 games. He's plus 81 that year.
Never got a gold medal.
He's plus 81 that year.
Think about that, dude. If you're plus 23, you're really good. Like,
plus 100 2 years later.
Wow. Okay, yeah, that argument's over. But you think
163 assists? Are you kidding me? How many points did that team score that year? Because he had 215 of them.
Oh, well, they were pretty good there for a stretch.
Beer,
yeah. I gotta think about that one for a second. Holy fucking Christ, dude.
His off years were like 40 and 43 goals.
Like, that's Michael Jordan shit. Like, that's why they're in commercials together.
That's beyond Jordan.
I like it.
Jordan never put up 92 fucking hockey goals.
And Gretzky never gambled so much that he got his dad killed either.
Jesus.
I don't give a fuck. So, I think Obi, how many years do you think he's got left, honestly?
I read something. If he plays six and scores a goal a game, he'll pass Wayne.
Really?
It might not even have been 6 years. It was like four or five or something like that.
I honestly think he's got five really good years left in him.
Well, if he averages a goal a game throughout that five-year period, not even, because he's only, what, Gretzky ended with like eight-something?
Well, Ovi's never had a long playoff run, so his seasons always end early.
Gretzky ended with 894. But I think that is counting – this is counting some of his WHL goals. This is his overall career. So I don't think that 894 is official NHL.
Why the fuck would they count his dub numbers into that?
Oh, here. Yeah, hang on. It shows it. It switches it. It says NHL career and then it says WHL career.
Go to HockeyDB.
894 NHL career.
Ovi's not beating that, dude.
1,963 assists.
Jesus fucking Christ.
2,857 total points.
Oh, well, I'm naming my next kid Wayne, then.
Yeah, what do you think Brett Garrish is named fucking Wayne?
Is he named after Gretzky?
Yeah, he's named after George Brett, third baseman for the Kansas City Royals.
That can't be that. If I didn't know his dad, I'd say that's not true.
Yeah. If you like didn't know Nick at all, you'd be like, you're lying. But after meeting Nick, you'd be like, oh, this is definitely why his kid's name's Brett Wayne.
Yeah, for sure. What did he name
his? Listen to this story. This is 1989, and Nick Garrish is playing fantasy hockey on pen and paper because no one else in the world is even playing fantasy sports.
Is this a true story?
100% true. His brother, Scott, which if anyone from Richland County is listening, they probably know who he was because he's a freak of nature athlete just like Nick. Scott and him are doing this draft with their friends. I think their older brother was in it too. No one knows his name. Younger brother, actually, I think. But
The summer I lived in Flint in a car, I bought that car from Scott.
Yeah, Scott rules. His brother Scott comes up to him and says, I'm drafting this rookie, Jaromir Jagr. He's going to be the next real deal, Evander Holyfield. And fucking Nick said he still can't believe it because, like, his brother drafted him in that fantasy year and no one knew who the fuck he was.
Well, dude, what's weird about that is our nephew, Beckett, his uncle, Tim, Brennan's – it's his wife. Her dad bought Yamir Yager rookie cards and what was that, 91?
I want to say 89, not 90.
Yeah, I think you're right. But it was because there was like a buzz about that. I mean, as much as he was unheard, there was like – it was that new thing of these guys being able to actually come over and play. And,
yeah.
And there was some weird buzz. Like, I think Tim said he went to the card store and was like – the card owner, the store owner was like, hey – you know, you should buy these two rookie cards. So I don't know if he was just trying to get rid of fucking two hockey cards, like rookie hockey cards or whatever. But he ended up buying two fucking Yager cards that day and just gave them to our nephew for his first birthday.
Oh, nice.
And pristine fucking never seen the sunlight in cases, full mullet, fucking beautiful. So I'm sure... if they're not by that signed Ryan Ellis puck in Brennan's basement, I'm going to puke.
Fuck Ryan Ellis.
That's bullshit, dude. Ryan Ellis is awesome.
Nick was he sent me a picture not too long ago.
How the fuck did they – I didn't even know dudes did fantasy shit back then.
Him and his friends did it on paper and just pencil, notepads, because they didn't have anything else.
Did they ever get laid?
I mean, Brett's here.
Yeah, no condom.
That same year, 89.
Fucking riding high off a fucking draft, I guess.
Riding high off that Yager train.
Well, speaking
of... He sent me a picture of those action figures. I can't think of the names.
Tough Dudes?
No, the sports collectible ones where they're like...
Starting lineup.
Yeah, he sent me three pictures of the Yager ones he has unopened still.
What?
And I'm pretty sure he wants to give them to me. That's why he sent them to me. Maybe. I'm going to ask for them regardless. He has the one with the fucking throwback Capitals jersey with the sick eagle.
From Yager's Capitals day?
In that sweet jersey, the one with fucking eagle, the American looking sweet one, the blue one.
I don't know that.
A Penguins one and a Boston, or a Philly one. He has a Penguins, Philly, and a Capitals starting lineup, Yager, in, packaged, everything.
Why the fuck does he have those?
He's a huge hockey fan, like, super, like, secretive about it. Like,
is he really?
When we were little, he was, like, a fucking diehard Red Wings fan, I think.
Yeah, a lot of fucking idiots from here were.
Well, that's because there wasn't anything.
Well, it's like fucking Eric Fike, still a fucking Red Wings fan. It makes me sick.
Yeah, I think Nick is a Jackets fan now because he always feeds me shit about the Penguins. But he said growing up he was Red Wings.
Oh, yeah. He was a fan of the fucking eight-time – or when he was young, they were probably only like six-time Stanley Cup champions, but still.
Well, he was young. It was Hal.
So well, I talked about this with Scott from Akula and Bridesmaid. You know, it was – if you lived here, it was like this in this area of like, are you going to be a Red Wings fan, a Penguins fan, or like a Blues fan? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it was like a weird, and a lot of people from, you know, where we're at in Ohio.
Or Blackhawks even.
Oh, yeah. Or Chicago. But a lot of people from this area are from Michigan because of GM.
Yeah, that's true.
I forgot the Blackhawks are a team.
Especially Mansfield, little Detroit, basically.
I mean, I've spent a lot of time in Flint, Michigan, and the similarities that Mansfield and Flint share are uncanny.
Disturbing.
Well, it's like Mansfield is what, like the way people act about Mansfield is what Flint actually is.
Yeah, that's true.
But I love it. Going up here soon.
They're out.
But I still can't name a better Russian than Ovi. This gone off the fucking rails.
a better Russian athlete?
Yes, period, athlete.
Man.
And the dude from Rocky doesn't count.
I was just about to say that, too.
Bonus points if you can say his name.
Me?
Yeah, say his name. Say my name!
Me. Are you talking to me?
Yeah. Quit stalling and say it.
You're talking to me.
Yes, I'm talking to you.
Ivan Dragic or Drago.
Whatever. See, you can't even fucking say it. Drago, yeah.
All right, better Russian athlete. This guy's named Seaman, so he's got my vote. Seaman Elostrov.
Was he a wrestler?
His Russian short track speed.
Yeah, get the fuck out of here with that.
Bronze medal in 2014.
I won a bronze medal last year. A fucking bronze medal.
I can't find them. I'm seriously like searching for like all-time Russian athletes.
There isn't one better than Ovi.
Seaman is on 93%.
I will tell you, there's one athlete better than Alex Ovechkin from Russia, and it's Sergei Fedorov.
Gino.
Or maybe Khabib Nurmagomedov in the UFC. But he's still young, so the book's out on him. Gino's up there. So is Pavel Bure and fucking Pavel Datsyuk.
Yeah, I mean, Datsyuk's a beast.
I mean, Datsyuk's got to be in your top 10. And I don't know those fucks from the 80 team, but they obviously get kicked off the list because they got fucking Stute slapped by Arusioni.
Yeah, I know one guy, Boris Mikhailov or something like that.
Yeah. Did you ever think of that penguin's name?
Yeah, Sergei Gonchar.
Ah!
That's when you were going to ask that next.
Yeah,
he even coaches for the Penguins right now.
That's how fucking stupid you are.
he's been assistant coach for him and Malkin celebrated the cup last year in Russia together because he was assistant coach. And I couldn't think of his name.
I wonder how many fucking like coked out skinny white chicks that those two gang banged together, like family style fucked.
I don't know, I'll send you a picture right now of one.
Hey, your boy Ron Francis got fired up. Did you see that?
No.
Well, he got fired as general manager, but he's like the president of operations or whatever.
Yeah.
For Carolina. So it's a more, you know, quote unquote prestigious job. But the new owner of the Hurricanes basically doesn't fucking like him. And expect to see him not a part of the organization next year.
That's a bummer.
It's weird, isn't it? But you know what that means. He'll just go work for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, I mean, they did win two cups with Mario, so I'm sure they're friends.
Well, he won't be a general manager or anything. It's not like Rutherford's getting fired or any shit like that.
No, but I could see him bringing him in.
And I know for a fact that dude that owns the new Carolina team is taking that team to Quebec. He has to.
You think so?
It's the only reason to buy that fucking team. There's no reason to have that team. Are they in North Carolina? Are they in Raleigh?
I am not positive.
It's fucking stupid to have that team there. I've never met a Hurricanes fan in my life.
I don't even think he's a Hurricanes fan. I think he just played there after he left Pittsburgh.
Was he the general manager when they won the cup? What year, when was that was early in their franchise organization, wasn't it?
I'm not sure. What year did they win it, you know?
Oh, fuck. The Hurricanes.
Carolina.
06? 02? No, 02 is Detroit.
You were right with 06.
Was it 06?
Yeah.
Okay. Isn't that weird that they won the fucking cup in 2006?
He wouldn't have been on that team. There's no way he played that.
No, there's no way he played, but he was definitely – I think that was like one of his first seasons as general manager there or some shit.
He might have still been playing. He left and went somewhere else after that.
He played after the Hurricanes?
Yeah.
Well, that's fucking unfortunate.
That team had Matt Collin on it.
Mac who?
Matt Collin.
Was he really on that team?
Yeah.
He has three cups?
Yeah, he rules.
Man, I feel... Minnesota's right in there, aren't they?
This year?
Yeah, I think they're... Are they in third still on the fucking Central?
Minnesota... I don't think it's third, but...
They're right there. Like, I mean, they still have hopes.
Look.
I really think Dubnyk is a fucking stellar fucking goalie.
Yeah. Minnesota's third in the Central.
Okay. I mean, I don't think they'll win it, but shit. I mean, Colin, it seems like wherever he goes, it's just fucking winners.
Yeah. Apparently.
Speaking, I wanted to mention the dudes from Spit and Chicklets, the Rear Admiral, was talking about this movie called Five Ring Films. Have you heard of this?
Five Ring what?
Films. It's like on the Olympic Channel.
No.
And it's about the 1998 Winter Olympics, the first year that the NHL sent athletes to the Olympics. It's a documentary. I highly, highly recommend you watch it. I DVR'd it and watched it. It's a fucking fascinating story. You know, Canada and United States were the favorites until you run into a team that has Jaromír Jágr and Dominik Hasek on it.
Yeah, do you want to know who the GM was for that Carolina team?
Do I know him?
Yeah, personally.
Oh, shit.
Jim Rutherford.
Was it fucking really? Are you fucking serious?
Yep.
What was Ron Francis doing? He was a part of that fucking team, wasn't he?
Probably, but I don't know.
Dude, I think he fucking played on that fucking team.
Helped them win a cup, then the Penguins win a cup.
Was he playing? There's no way he was playing in 2006.
Ron Francis?
Yes.
I gotta find out now.
Got a fucking Ron Francis card right here in my hand.
It's only going to go back 3 years.
No, it's a Pinnacle 96-97. Only goes back 1 year.
Jesus fuck.
As one of the NHL's most savvy players, Francis feasts on power play chances. He had
four... Now, in 2004, he played 12 games with the Maple Leafs and then called it a year.
Oh, fucking loser. Oh, Larry Murphy.
Fucking loser.
Yeah, but you should watch that movie for sure. It's really fucking good. Jonathan Cheechoo, I want to give a biscuit approved to him. He just put up the skates for good, retired. One of those unsung heroes, dude. Somebody that you would not mention as a Rocket Ricard winner, and you know, he did it. In 05-06 with the Sharks, 56 goals.
First Shark ever.
Was that the first year?
First Shark to win the...
Oh, to win the Rocket.
Yeah.
He's a Cleveland Baron in the minors and a fucking Shark, and then ended up finishing his career in the KHL. Over 500 games played and 170 goals and 305 points. So, you know, crack open some bats for Jonathan Cheechoo. What a fucking hell of a dude.
Yeah, and he only played like 4 years in NHL. And, like, read those stats. Like, that's nuts.
Yeah, that's what I thought was freaky. Like, he really only played like 4 or 5 seasons. So he played like every game every year and just dominated.
6 seasons in NHL.
So I wonder what happened with him where, like, if he – because I've heard a lot of this shit with, like, Vince Young and Matt Leinhart talking about, you know, getting drafted at a team and, like, running into the wrong coach and, like, just getting your career fucking ruined.
Yeah, but I mean, he was playing pretty fucking well to have that happen.
I mean, maybe that was just his prime, and then that was it.
I don't know. But yeah, when that was, he basically my entire high school career from freshman year to senior, he was there and then left.
But like, he went under the radar, even went in the Rocket. I don't remember, like, I don't really remember Jonathan Cheechoo. Do you?
Do you remember anything in the year 2007?
Do I?
Yeah.
No, I have severe head trauma.
So that's my point. I was a senior that year.
Oh, 07 is like...
Oh, 06 is when he won. 07, he just, yeah, never mind.
So,
either way, 06, I'm not sure. Your 19-year-old self wasn't remembering that.
No, 06 and 07, I was doing a lot of Robitussin. That's for sure. I forgot how to throw a baseball that year.
How are you going to remember that Jonathan Cheechoo won the Rocket when you can't throw a baseball?
I don't feel as bad about forgetting about it now because I just remembered that I forgot how to throw a baseball back in 07.
Yeah, and that's when he was tearing it up.
Well, good for you, Jonathan Cheechoo. And I mean, he played professional hockey from like 1997 until 2017. That's fucking impressive.
Yeah, it is.
Did you watch the Wednesday Night Rival last week?
Was it Pitt, Philly?
Yes.
Not all of it.
Did you? I hope you watched the first period with Pierre and the linebacker from the Eagles.
After everyone started talking about it, it started getting outrageous.
It was one of the most awkward things I'd ever seen, like ever on TV. It was like they had zero chemistry together. The dude was literally what player was it from the Super Bowl champions?
I'm not sure.
It's a linebacker, like Michael something.
Michael something?
He played with Michael Bennett, too, back in the day.
I'm not sure. Let me look it up.
I don't know. It doesn't fucking matter.
But yeah, it was...
Dude.
You could get on Twitter during that game, and it was nuts. Michael Kendricks.
Yeah, I don't know who he is, and I watched the Super Bowl.
Quote, unquote, he said before they went on the air that this is going to be so dope.
Yeah, he said that a couple times. And then Pierre was like, what do you think? And he's like, I'm still waiting for a fight. And Pierre was like so mad that like, oh, people want to see fights in hockey? And then like he said it again. So then they played an old video from like a game earlier in the year when what's the homeboy for the Penguins defenseman? Olinskia or whatever fucking fought?
Yeah, yeah.
And, like, he kept trying to fucking suck Michael's dick during, like, the thing. Like, it was so weird, man. It was so fucking weird. I kept watching it because I was like, I can't believe they're just going to let this happen. Like, they let that dude commentate the first period.
Yeah. Everyone on Twitter was talking about the announcers.
It was so fucking weird, dude. And then I went on YouTube today, and there's a top 10 Pierre's weirdest moments. I only got to number 7. I had to turn it off. That dude's fucking weird, man. A few more things here before we get out of here. I see it's getting later in the evening. I think there's a candidate for Fight of the Year with winner Luke Witkowski versus Minnesota Sealer. Did you see that fight?
Nick Sealer?
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, I've watched it. I watched it 5 minutes before we started talking.
They opened up a can on each other. It was awesome.
Yeah, I mean, if you're just going to give it Fight of the Year right off the bat, we didn't even have a poll or...
No, I mean, we'll have a poll, but I mean, it's my nominee for Fight of the Year.
What about fucking Super Punch?
Oof. Ugh, yeah, we'll have to send us your Fight of the Years because Bieska, I mean, yeah, he had two of those this year.
Yeah, what about when Reeves might have killed a guy?
Yeah, McDermott had a couple fucking good tosses too this year.
Who was that dude's name Reeves hit? For Nashville.
Austin Watson?
Just cold cocked him.
Was that who it was, Ashton Watson?
I'm not sure if it was them. Is he 51?
Cody McLeod.
He knocked his fucking dick off. Broke his jaw. That was insane.
I don't know. Find that fight. Send it to me.
There's been a bunch of good ones this year. Super Punch. Reeves had a Super Punch.
Reeves had a Super Punch? Taylor,
I mean, every punch is a Super Punch from him.
Jesus Christ. He can't. He's a Golden Knight.
Witkowski and Sealer beat the trash out of us. So that's the fight where Sealer's bleeding from the nose.
Yeah, and then they give fucking Witkowski the instigator, even though they both fucking dropped at the same time.
Yeah, sometimes they do some weird stuff with that.
Oh, sometimes? But what the point is, Witkowski and Thorburn got fight of the year last year on the biscuit. So he's up 2 years in a row.
Nice.
Vegas Golden Knights going forward. Do you think them having absolutely zero playoff experience is going to shit on them? Or do you think that these guys are just that good that it doesn't fucking matter?
Zero playoff experience? What do you mean zero?
Zero.
What's this dick from the Blue Jackets didn't play in the playoffs last year?
Barely.
Barely, yeah. Okay. Marc-Andre Fleury don't have three cups?
Barely.
James Neal didn't play in the Stanley Cup and play in multiple playoff games with the Penguins?
Barely. Yeah, you make good points. Never mind, I'll go fuck myself on that.
Has David Perron played in the playoffs? He's the former Penguin.
He played with the Blues, too, so that doesn't help you.
Yeah, but he might have played in the playoffs.
My boy Pat.
Is it Carlson?
Yeah.
Who the Jackets should have kept?
Oh, for sure.
Clearly.
I said that when it happened, man.
Jesus criminy. Dude's playing. I can understand getting rid of, like, Perron and Neil and some of these dudes that teams got rid of, but why did they get rid of Carlson?
Because we wanted to keep Josh Anderson and Matt Calvert.
Holy shit.
Yeah, when it happened, I was like, we're going to regret losing William Carlson, and then he goes and is like on the cusp of 40 goals. Plus minus of like plus 33. And then also, literally, is one of the best defending like centers in the league.
Yeah, and with Fleury, I mean, they have a chance to beat anybody.
I don't think they'll beat the Ducks in the second round.
I don't think Fleury has another run in them. I think he's got another crazy series. But if you noticed in the last back-to-back Stanley Cup champion wins by the Penguins,
he don't make it all the way.
No. He had to have Matt Murray.
Well, I mean, Matt Murray's first year, nobody saw that coming, so maybe there's a kid. Maybe it's Malcolm Subban.
No. That's when your playoff experience comes in. I think if anything happens to Fleury, you call it. And he is one. He is a guy that when you might be up 3-1, but I watched him go up 3-1 against New York Rangers, and I watched him lose three games straight. And I will say him because there was a game the Penguins had like 83 shots against Henrik.
Yeah.
And lost because they gave up like five goals. I mean, I've watched Fleury give up 3-1s. I've watched him. I mean, he can be lights out, but he can be just as shitty in the playoffs. That's why every Penguin wanted to get rid of him.
Well, needless to say, a lot of people are going to be tuning into those Vegas games.
Yeah, did you hear what he said?
Who?
Everyone's talking about the Vegas Blue, and that's why teams can't go there and win.
Oh, yeah.
Fleury said we must take the flu with us on the road.
That sounds like a fucking goalie answer.
But I do agree with you to some extent. I mean, if it's game seven and you're in
Vegas, you're in Vegas, they have fucking home ice.
Oh, yeah, that helps.
Yeah, so they, I mean, home ice, because the Vegas flu is real. It might not be real next year after all these teams went there for a year and they go, oh, okay, now we know how to do Vegas.
Do you think it's going to be real during the playoffs, though?
Absolutely, I do.
Because when it comes playoffs, you're going to have a different atmosphere and a different...
Yeah, do you know how much better playoff cocaine is?
In that locker room.
Do you hear me?
Yeah, I heard you.
Yeah. Patrick Laine, 41 and counting. Looks like I'm not so dumb.
Yeah, well, it looks like I picked Ovi, so.
Well, fuck. And the last thing before we get out of here, Big Ran, I was thinking about Michael Haley and the Florida Panthers. So far this year, he's leading with 20 fighting majors. So I wanted to see what Florida's record was in games that he fights in. It's 10-6-1.
Yeah, so not that good.
Well, they win more often than not when he fights. That's all I'm saying.
Has he fought in the last month?
Yeah, he's fought on March 1st, 2nd, 6th, and the 10th. They've won three out of those four.
He's keep fighting people, I guess.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, and the intro check's playing real good. He's on my fantasy team.
Well, the point is that this whole you're going to lose if you fight is it's just not – it's not a real thing.
No.
Big Ran, tell them where to find us. It gets fucking worse every
Spotify.
Week.
Spotify. SpotifyRadio.com.
Just go rate us on iTunes. Give us 5 stars. Leave a review, please. We're on every... Obviously...
Spotify app. Don't use the Spotify app. Go to their website, Spotify.com. /radio.
Obviously, if you're listening to us, you have found us. We appreciate all you guys. Thanks for listening. We'll see you next week. How many bucks